With patch 12.9 in Escape from Tarkov, we received some very decent changes, and one of them is that the SR-25 is right now very viable. The SR-25 in Escape from Tarkov is in my top 3 most favorite weapons, and I'm going to show you some very nice builds and the reason why. Escape... Well, I wanted to start the video and my skiffs brought some loot, let's check them out. Dear comrades, Ivan the German is back for you guys out there. Glad to see you again. And first of all, I'm very happy that Pistilli has his YouTube channel back. But let's continue with the topic of today's video. And I'm going to show you why the SR-25 is one of the best weapons in Escape from Tarkov right now. And why it is a big mistake that you are not using the SR-25. So grab a beer or two or a drink. It is weekend and let's start with the video. So I brought to you two SR-25 builds. And the reason is quite simple. You can see it right now. One is the 16-inch barrel version. And the other one is the 20-inch barrel version. Why do we have both of them? Because both are very great. The 20-inch version is a little bit more expensive because you have to pay for the extra barrel, but in my opinion, my go-to is the 16-inch barrel, because even if we have 61 recoil, vertical recoil, you have 40 ergonomics, which is great without a magazine and a sight and a tactical light. You will have, with all of them combined, around 35 ergonomics, but it feels much better than 61 vertical recoil. Maybe it's because some hidden stats, like Nikita confirmed, the center of mass, but the SR-25 is a very strong gun, believe me guys, it's very rare. And the reason why it is so good in Escape from Tarkov patch 12.9 is the combination of this 6-hour suppressor. And the reason behind it is quite simple. The 2-port break will give you extra minus 11% recoil. On the flea market, the 6-hour suppressor is way cheaper compared to Peacekeeper. You have to pay him 500 bucks. And what you also can do is go to Skier and you can trade a Raven for one SRD QD suppressor. And a Raven is quite cheap, 28k, so you can save a lot of money. With the 20-inch barrel version, you will lose 9 ergo, which means we have 31 ergonomics, but only 50 recoil. This is insane with the SR-25. But in my opinion, you're even very good to go with the 16-inch version. So you have a little bit more ergo, your weapon is not that long, and the SR-25 is brutal. As you can see right here, I have a full recoil build, and that's important because the reason behind it, it's quite simple. I tried it out the last days to play with a high ergo build and very low ergo, but in my opinion, especially with some semi-automatic weapons, you have to stay on target. If you're not the best player in Escape from Tarkov, or if you don't have the best gaming chair in Escape from Tarkov and you are not one-tapping everything, you have to stay on target. That means you have to have a very low recoil because you need those extra shots in your target, or you will lose the fight. You will lose against some fully automatic weapons, or you will lose in general. In my opinion, I think a lot of guys are playing some wrong ergo builds and they are complaining about fully automatic weapons or everything else. In my opinion, I love semi-automatic weapons in Escape from Tarkov. I think they are better because your time to kill, if you aim properly and if you are on target, is less compared to some fully automatic weapons. So AR-15s and 416s in Escape from Tarkov are great. They have some mediocre damage, they have some nice penetration with 9.95, I know that. But compare them to M61, you will do a lot of damage and a lot of penetration. But in my opinion, it needs a little bit more skill to play semi-automatic weapons, because you have to tap fire, of course, you have to stay in target, and you have to control the recoil a little bit more because you have every time this initial jump. So as you can see here, this is the part list, and of course I will make a pinned comment about the parts you need, and this will cost you a little bit under 200k. You have to pay 120k for the parts, around 50k, it really depends of the current day, around 50k for the SR, maybe 60k, and also can save some ruble, as I said, if you bought the suppressor. Let's talk about the ammunition real quick. In my opinion, your way to go is M61. Why M61? Compared to the M1A, you don't have 30 or 50 round max, you only have 20, so you have to make sure that if you are hitting your target, you do penetrate and you are able to kill it. Of course you can play M80. M80 is great in my opinion. You still have some decent armor pen and very high damage. So especially against Scav, Scav boss and Raider, M80 is great. Level 4 and 5 armor is still, M80 is still okay, especially level 4. But the thing is, it is worth to buy M61. It is worth to play the SR-25 with M61. You don't need that much shots to take your enemy down. and of course you don't need that much rounds compared to some fully automatic weapons. That's why in my opinion M61 is the go-to. If you don't care, you can play M62. It is a little bit better compared to M80, but it's not worth the extra cost. M80 costs you $3, M62 $6, double the price. In my opinion, it's not worth. So if you don't care, you can play M62, you can play M80, my go-to is M61. Of course you can play M993, but in my opinion it's a little bit over the top. Because you will lose some flash damage, you gain some armor pen, you don't need that, M61 is great, and the price for M993 is very high. Let's talk about the magazines real quick. The first option is the Knights Armament Steel Mag 20 round. It is okay, because you will only lose 4 ergonomics. The PMAG 20 round is a little bit more expensive and you will get them a little bit later and you will only lose minus 3 ergonomics. Not a big difference, and if you can't buy the PMAG from the trader, the price difference is quite high, because as you can see right here, 38k from the flea if you can't buy it from the trader and 23k for the Knights Mag, but you can buy the Steel Mag from Peacekeeper a little bit earlier. So you can play the SR a little bit earlier also. With this build, you are able to use some long range scopes, of course, some Voodoo or some Weldays, but I'm running it with some Red Dots, EOTechs and all of that stuff, high mounted RMR on customs almost all the time. I push dorms or new constructions quite a lot, or made some marked room runs with the SR-25. Works perfect with a red dot sight on it. And now I'm going to show you the recoil. First round, as always, no recoil control with the 16-inch barrel SR-25. Let's compare it right now with some decent recoil control. This was the 16-inch barrel. Not a big problem with some rough recoil control, we still have a lot of shots in our target. Let's compare it with the 20-inch barrel and some decent recoil control. As you can see, it is much smoother, but in my opinion you are good to go with the 16-inch barrel. So what is my summary about the SR-25? I had a lot of fun making this video about the SR-25 because in my opinion this build, or this weapon in general in Escape from Tarkov, is very rare, and I do not know why, because it is so powerful. The SR-25 is a little weaker ersatz, but the SR-25 is cheaper and it's a little bit shorter compared to the ersatz. And of course you can play the M1A. The M1A is great in my opinion, of the best weapons in Escape from Tarkov, and right behind we have the SR-25. It sounds great, it looks cool, and with patch 12.9, Battlestate Games made a really good weapon out of the SR-25. I played solo almost all the time in my clips, which I'm showing you right now, and I played against a lot of squads and they had almost no chance. Especially if you're facing a single target, you can tap them down so quickly, they do not know what's going on. If you are not so comfortable with some proper recoil control, or if you do not like some fully automatic weapons, if you want to try something different, try the SR-25 or some other semi-automatic weapons. It needs a little bit more skill, of course, because you have to tap fire. So I really can't wait what you think about the SR-25 in Escape from Tarkov. Right now, leave a comment in the comment section below. And as always, in the end of our videos, do not forget to like our videos, because your support is so important for us to show the world that we Germans can win at least something. And if it's your like, I would really appreciate it. So see you in the next video, guys. Bye.